Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Navin Nayak. In today's prelim shots, we are going to learn about environment impact assessment. It is one of the important topic in UPSC CSC, and it is very important that every aspirant should know about this topic. And without waiting, let's see the what is impact assessment. Environment impact assessment. Environment impact assessment is a tool which helps to evaluate the environment impacts of proposed development projects or programs. It ensures that the mitigation strategies are included in the plan and the project under construction is environmentally sound and within limits of the capacity of assimilation and regeneration capacities of the ecosystem. And we can see in this definition that environment impact assessment, it is a very important assessment to know that project which any of the project which impacts the environment or not. And after doing this assessment, the permission is granted by respective central government or state government. And let's see what are the objectives of environment impact assessment. Objectives of environment impact assessment: to serve as a primary environment clearance tool, to assess consistently all proposals for potential environment impacts, to suggest the use of scientific practice and strategies for mitigation, to address all possible factors such as short term, long term, small scale and large scale impacts, to include mechanism for monitoring, auditing and evaluation. And these are the objectives of impact environment impact assessment. Environment impact assessment in India was introduced in the India in 1978 with respect to river valley projects. Environment impact assessment notification come under the provision of Environment Protection Act 1986. Please remember, we have to remember Environment Protection Act 1986. Environment impact assessment is not mandatory for mandatory for red category projects and other such categories as per notification of the ministry released in 2016, and these projects get environment clearance only after environment impact assessment requirements are fulfilled. Environment impact assessment comes under notification on environment impact assessments of development projects 1994 under the provision of Environment Protection Act 1986. And see the what are the components of environment impact assessment. And first one is air environment, quality of ambient air, wind speed, direction, humidity, etc., quality of emissions likely from projects, impacts of the emission on the area, pollution control desires, air quality standards. And second one is noise, levels of noise present and predicted, strategies for reducing noise pollutions. And third one is water environment, existing ground and surface water resources, their quality and quantity within the zone, impact of proposed projects on water resources. And fourth one is biological environment, flora and fauna in the impact zone, potential damage due to project, due to effluent, emissions and landscaping, biological stress, and land environment, study of soil characteristic, land use, the drainage pattern and the likely adverse impacts of the project, impacts on historical monuments and heritage sites. And these are the components of environment impact assessment. And after doing this procedure, they will grant the permission for the any projects like industries, mining and etc., which affects projects which are related to environment. Environment clearance or go go ahead signal is granted by the impact assessment agency in the Ministry of Environment Affairs. Ministry of Environment, all projects that require clearance from central government can be broadly categorized into the following industries. These are the categories of the environment impact assessments. What are the projects that require environment impact assessments are industrials, mining, thermal power plants, river valley projects, infrastructure and coastal regulation zone, nuclear power projects. Steps in environment impact assessment process, and these are the steps they do before the granting the permission for that particular project. And first step is screening. Second is scoping and consideration of alternatives, and if there is a damage and if the project affects the environment, and they go for any alternative for protection they see. And third one is baseline data collection, fourth one impact prediction, fifth one assessment of alternatives, delineation of mitigation measures and environment impact statement, sixth one is public hearing, seventh one decision making, monitoring and implementation of environment management plan. And we can see in sixth one, public hearing, it is a very important that the people's live around that project, their opinions has to be taken. And next step is proceed. Main participants of environment impact assessment. Environment impact assessment apply to public and private sections. The six main players are those who propose the project, the environment consultant who prepared environment impact assessment on behalf of project proponent, third one pollution control board or state or national, and fourth one is public has the right to express their opinions, and fifth one the impact assessment agencies, and sixth one is regional center of the Ministry of Environment. And let's see the environment impact assessment notification 2006. It is a very important notification. The objective of environment impact assessment notification 2006 is to address the limitations in the old environment impact assessment notification 1994. It is a updated notification of 2006 and silent futures. More number of projects brought within the preview of the environment clearance process. A revised list of projects and activities have been redrawn that requires prior environment clearance, doing away with the category of projects requiring environment impact assessment based on investment. And now the size or capacity of the project determines whether it is cleared by the center or state government. The major difference in the new environment impact assessment notification 2006 from the earlier one 1994 is its attempt to decentralize powers to the state government. It is very important to know. And earlier all the projects under schedule 1 went to the central government for environment clearance. However, as per the new notification, a significant number of projects will go to the state for clearance depending on its size, capacity or area. The environment impact assessment notification 2006 broadly divided all projects into two categories. And in 1994, there are two schedules of schedule 1 and schedule 2 in 1994, and in 2006 they divided the all projects into two categories, category 1, category A and category B, based on potential impacts over an area and on human health and natural and man-made resources. All category A projects are required to carry out an environment impact assessment and undertake a public hearing before an environment clearance may be granted by the Union Environment Ministry. Category A projects includes all physical infrastructure whose size and cost is greater than certain minimum levels as defined in the schedule. And environment clearance for these projects are granted at the central level. And physical infrastructure includes projects in the ports, highways, and water and sanitation, urban transport, and solid waste management sector. And all new national highways are classified as category A. In addition, expansion of national highway greater than 30 kilometers involving land acquisition and passing through more than one state are categorized as category A. In category B, we see the category B covers projects with lesser size or capacity and smaller impacts than category A. Category B projects are evaluated and given a clearance by state level authority. Category A is given permission by central government, and category B permission is given by state government. The State Environment Impact Assessment Authority and State Expert Appraisal Committee. The project under B1 also requires an environment impact assessment and public consultation, but those falling under B2 are exempted from requirements of both environment impact assessment and public consultation. The new notification also talks about scoping, which are completely missing earlier issue pertaining to draft environment impact assessment notification 2020. And this is all about the environment impact assessment. And thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thank you.